I'll be honest, when I finally got around to playing ukulele, I was pretty disappointed, and I was left in a deep state of depression as I came to the crushing realization that there may very well never be another game that did it like Banjo. I was lost and confused until one day, hidden beneath the very crust of the earth, buried underneath the molten lava, and hidden behind a 6-inch steel door, was a shiny new ROM hack that I somehow had never heard of before. And we're not talking about a Mario 64 hack. No, man. This was a fucking Banjo hack. This was Banjo Dreamy. And this, my friends, is something else. The original Banjo-Kazooie is a timeless classic. The graphics were great, the levels are large and vivid, the music is catchy as anything, and Banjo and Kazooie just make a great team. Using all sorts of moves and techniques to hunt down all the shiny things, as usual. But how does this ROM hack compare? Right off the bat, you'll realize that you have very little mobility. All you can do is walk and do a really shitty jump. Just like the beginning of Banjo-Kazooie. In the original, Bottles would ask you if you wanted to learn all the basic moves, and I expected that to happen here. Not so. Throughout the game, you will find these molehills where Bottles teaches you a move. So you spend a lot of the game with very limited mobility, but gradually, you become more adept. It's actually a pretty cool concept. Right now, you'll only be able to access some of this level. But head on over to the next level, you'll get a move that allows you to come back here and go further until you hit another roadblock and have to venture to another level where you'll find more roadblocks. And then you'll have to venture even further, the cycle repeats, etc. Now, while I like this concept, what hurts it is the fact that every time you exit a level and re-enter, you have to get all the notes all over again. Just like in Banjo-Kazooie. Of course, in the original, there wasn't nearly as much backtracking. For all the levels, if you played them in the order which they were meant to be played, you could collect all the notes in one run and not have to worry about getting them again. A luxury which you don't have in this game. A lot of people complained about backtracking in Banjo-Tooie, but in that game, when you get the notes, you got the notes. They were yours, permanently. Now, fortunately, there are only 25 notes on each level, so it's not game-breaking. In that respect, the gameplay is solid. The levels are fantastic. Despite being smaller than what you'd expect in Banjo-Kazooie, they look very authentic. They look like Banjo-Kazooie levels. If you were to imagine that most games had add-on content back in those days, this is exactly what a Banjo-Kazooie expansion pack would look like. The levels are elaborate and distinctive, the scenery is great to look at, there's little details here and there, there's a fucking ukulele painting inside of a hot spring. Did not expect that. And of course, throughout the game, you'll meet a number of familiar friends and foes. Notably, Captain Blubber, who's just really depressed for some reason. And also the main antagonist, who is in fact not Grunty, but her toilet. That's right, Lago is the bad guy. He also happens to be the creator of this hack, so way to go, you fucking toilet man, or whatever. The music is just top-notch. One of the best parts of the Banjo games was the music, and this game does not disappoint. The music sounds just like something you'd hear in the official games. They even went as far as to make the music change depending on the environment. What a great thing. In terms of functionality, the game works perfectly well, except for this one part where Snacker somehow managed to attack me while I was in the sailboat. Man, fuck Jaws. Wasting all his time eating the boat away, this motherfucker just goes right through it like it's air. But that's Banjo Dreamy. I strongly recommend this one. It's great.